We will make this smooth vise from the scrap I bought from the junkyard. Hi, homecrafters all over the world. I am making this vise for my friend after he broke his. So we went to the scrap yard to buy some steel. And I brought back these rusty parts. The important thing is to keep the price low. Because if you buy it, the C-channel alone is at the same price as my commercial vise. I am cutting the ends, and I will not use my vise in this project. When you are cutting, let the disc do the job. And don't put pressure on it, because you will consume it fast, and it could even explode. Don't ask me how I know that. Measure twice and cut once. The first pass with the grinder is to trace the marked line, to make it easy on yourself to follow. And I think this is the most important step to get straight cuts. It is easy to mark on rusty steel. Now I will clean these parts, and if you can do it in an open place, that's better. I will not use this threaded rod because of its big knots. It is too hard to fit. Instead, I will use this M24, almost 1 inch in diameter. Clean the knots to get good weld. The problem when welding the nuts together is it became hard to open them. I tried this before with the same results. In my opinion, there is three solutions. The first is to use coupling nuts. The second is to use them until they grind each other. The third is this. I am welding the nuts to the base, using 7018. It needs a clean surface. I will use this as shims for the spacing between the parts. You can use thinner shims here to have tighter fit. I am welding a bit from one side and jumping to the other to minimize steel movement. I will make this part. This piece is thick, so I need to flip it to finish the cut. And you don't need to use piece this thick. You should drill here using drill bits same as the diameter of the threaded rod. I am using 20mm bits, because I will put some bearings inside. And you can do this instead, it is easier. This is my first time using this lathe in projects. I repaired it to be half usable, but it has a lot of broken gears, too expensive for me to repair. I have only this tool, so I will try to make it using it. I am facing this part and flipping it to register on the forge shaft. The ball bearing is to make turning the handle smooth and easy. And this thrust bearing is to make opening and closing the vise easy. Even my tail stuck on this lathe is broken. I forgot the bearing inside. Thank God it didn't get too hot. I will use this piece as a handle, and you can use a nut and weld it. Or like you see here, the inside part of bearing, and by heating it to red and letting it cool down slowly, you can drill through it. I will regret this. I broke the bit, but I removed it using this tweezer. I will change the way I fix the handle, because this is weak. Don't forget to use oil to cool the drill bit and reduce friction. I will decrease the size of the jaws, because this will cause weakness in the vise. Like it did happen to my friend's vise, it broke as a result of bad weld and the height of the jaws. You see, brothers, the disc is guiding itself. This isn't safe, but I am showing you this to see the pressure you will need, or better, not need to cut. I will weld wood to steel to brace the jaws in this vise. This piece is to mark the way I will cut to not waste steel and to make it easier. I always forget to wear my gloves. These parts are the most important in the vise jaws because they gave it a tremendous strength to handle the clamping forces without breaking. I am welding the jaws from the back only, and you can weld it from the inside, but I don't think that is necessary. Fastest weld in history. I am adding these pieces to make the mouth of the jaw thicker, to drill and tap through them. I will not grind this pattern in the removable jaws, because in my experience it will mark the clamped parts and could ruin it, and more contact surface means better holding power. I will use this train rail as a small anvil. This part is long because I was going to put a leaf spring as an anvil. This nut to stop the bearing from messing the threads. And if you did use the spring, it will stop it from backing off. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like. That means a lot to me. I changed this bolt because it almost broke from the root of the thread, so I used this that passed through the handle. It is obligatory to use it to crush steel. What I like about this vise is that it can clamp what mine couldn't. These are the holes on my friend's table. He brought me the measurements the most accurate way known to man, on a cardboard box. As eye protection, I'm using my old diving goggles. They seal well. Greasing is to reduce rust over time and friction. I told my friend to take my vise instead of this, but the smart one refused. Very smooth motion, I like it.